really set the world alight with this wonderful young horse owned by Reddy Luard and Carl Hester, with a 78.830, only the sixth time, I believe, that they had done a Grand Prix test. And it's important that we mention the team over here. Fiona Lawrence is here with Vallegro, normally non-travelling head girl from Carl's Yard. But she's come over here with the team as they've got two horses here for Grey Britain, Charlotte, Jeanne, and Vallegro.
It's a lovely start. Look at this. Oh. Wow. That's 8.5 of anyone's money. 9.2, they're giving a great, I'm so pleased. Lovely picture throughout the whole thing. Oh, glitch in the passage. Glitch, God, what a shame. Anticipating the extension, possibly. Extension for another 10, I heard. That's interesting, the passage took up the 8. Oh, canting. This is what happened though, it's just a little bit of tension on the hand. She's got a tiny bit in hand, but not much, Charlotte. You can't afford another mistake now. Now the 75 now because of the mistake on the half pass. Another really classy extension though. I think the neck and the contact are something with all of the energy. It's just one of the nicest contacts you're seeing for most of the time. Another lovely, relaxed walk. Easy, huge over track. Good rhythm still maintained into the walk. The trick is to keep this right up to the first step of the pier. So far she's done exactly. A little early on the Piaf, but she wisely took the Piaf when it was offered. A little forwards. Just a few glitches creeping in. Lovely, lovely piece of gear. Marginally forward, but really not that much. Probably he's looking more forwards on the camera than it is in reality. It's back up to 77%. Not an easy, not a clean strike off there, so that's a sort of a 6 at best. But when you have the judges on your side, they tend to think up rather than down, and let's hope they do that for Charlotte. Tighten the neck from this. this camera angle, but in actual fact, looking sideways on, it's nice and uphill, the half passes. Both of them are good. Oh, one mistake in the twos at the very end, second to last change. It's going to take it down a little bit. From this point of view, really lovely one-time changes, really beautiful.
In the background, 82.113, current leader, Adelinda Cornelissen.
Superb pirouette, really nice pirouette. Mistake in the ones. Just won't get away with that now. There's an extension.
Look at that.
Stunning, huh? Absolutely stunning. Only got a 5 for a 110 piece, so I hope he's got a great mark for that extension.
76, 77 are on its score, and percentage.
Yeah. Very, very high class, but not a good transition into the Piaf, a real hesitation into the Piaf. Yeah, just errors, you know. It's been a great championship, so she's just done the most amazing job. And maybe a little tired horse or whatever, and, you know, it's just not the greatest of days today, but still, what's going to come for next year at the Olympics?
The day, both of them, at the beginning of their career. Yeah.
Absolutely.
That's a minor thing. Charlotte Dujardin, formerly with Julie Harvey in the early years, then 4 years ago went to Carl Hester's yard from Judy's, got the ride on Vallegro, and
has a look back
within 7 months of her first Grand Prix, has a gold medal at the FEI European Dressage Championships. Scores are coming through on the screen in front of us. And interviews with many of the international riders will all be up for review on FEI TV. I've interviewed Charlotte 2 or 3 times, interviews are available. Hard to believe what's happened in the last few months, indeed the last few days. 76.533.
Amazing. I mean, what a great championship for it.
Yes, it was fantastic.